So TS of leaf, what is that? TS means a transverse section of leaf, where we can see, for example, if this is a leaf and if we cut this leaf, same leaf transversely, that means here it will appear like this. Like this it will appear, and then if we just isolate one portion and make a slide with the help of a slide and a cover slip, and that we focus under microscope, then we will observe the structure. So that is called as transverse section of leaf. So why it is important, transverse section of leaf? That means which parts are important. In fact, why this concept has come in? Earlier we discussed about cavatier and palatier and cavento. We have discussed about two scientists here. So in that cavento scientist said that entire leaf this chlorophyll is present. Later this palatier also said the same thing here, entire leaf this chloroplast is present. But this concept was wrong when Julius von Sack, he said that no, it is not present entirely. It is true for some extent, in fact they are present in cell organelles called as chloroplasts. So inside chloroplast chlorophylls are present. So this chlorophyll, that means if we indicate a leaf here, so the leaf we can see here, there is a part called as chloroplast, that is an organelle. Already you have drawn in a case of a plant cell an organelle called as chloroplast. Inside that pigments are present, green color pigments. So they are called as chlorophyll. This was said by Julius von Sack. So this person said that entire leaf it is present, but not on the leaf, inside the chloroplast these chlorophylls are present. So this person said. So then this made the discovery to find out what are present in the cells. So what are all present in the cells, we need to understand now. So for every leaf, what is present here? A smooth and shiny area. So this is called as cuticle. The upper region, can you see this region? This region is called as a cuticle. So this is the upper cuticle and this is the lower cuticle. So on back side of the leaf, it is a very shiner or shiny, and the upper region also very, very shiny. So this shiny layer will be given by cuticle. Here you can see the parts. Remember, most important, these parts are most important. So just below to that, a serial rectangular shaped upper epidermis. Upper means the upper region, epi means above, dermis means skin. So above skin is called as epidermis. So this is upper epidermis, same like that you can see the lower epidermis. But here you need to remember that upper epidermis is continuous, lower epidermis is discontinuous. Why? Because there are some parts are there here which are most important. Here it is continuous, whereas here discontinuous. Upper epidermis is continuous, lower epidermis is discontinuous. Why? Because in lower epidermis we can see stomata, god cell. So these two parts are covered with to form lower epidermis. So remember that. So they will ask in your SSC, what is the difference between upper epidermis and lower epidermis? Upper epidermis is continuous, it is continuous without any interruptions, but lower epidermis it has god cell and stomata. So here you can see this is the god cell, we will call this as god cell. Inside the stomata is present. Understood? Just below to that you can see still elongated double layer palisade parenchyma, only in case of upper region, we cannot see in the lower region. Lower region we can see spongy parenchyma, they are not elongated like this, they are wavy pattern or irregular in shape, leaving air sacs or air spaces. Understood? These won't leave any air spaces. Gaps are present, but they, these gaps we won't call it as air spaces. And remember that here, in case of a spongy parenchyma, air spaces are present. That's why it will be spongy in nature. So whenever if you want to sleep with a bed full of covered with the leaves, then you will feel it's like a spongy nature. That spongy nature you need to tank for spongy parenchyma. So this palisade parenchyma, you need to remember here, there are two layers, elongated cells, which consists of chloroplasts. These are called as chloroplast. Remember, I am saying here chloroplast. So chloroplasts are present here. So here total, in a case of palisade parenchyma and spongy parenchyma, chloroplasts are filled. And then between palisade parenchyma and spongy parenchyma, you can see xylem here. Understood? The upper region is called as xylem. The lower region is called as phloem. Xylem is important for water materials. Phloem is important for food. You need to remember that. Xylem is important for water transportation in a plant. Phloem is responsible for food transportation for the plant. And more, you need to remember here, phloem will help the food transport from upper region to lower region, whereas xylem will help water transport from lower region to upper region. Why? Because xylem, we are saying about water. Water is present inside the soil. Sometimes in rainy season you can find here, but maximum from the soil only. You can see conduction of this, and this xylem will conduct the water from opposite direction beyond gravity, and phloem will conduct food because due to gravity. Combination of these two is called as vascular bundle, BUNDLE. And vascular bundle means it is combination of xylem and phloem. So about spongy parenchyma, it gives a cushion like a feature for the leaf and living air spaces. And god cells are present here. God cells are like this, already you have from last year, like stomata. So stomata consists of two god cells, and which is filled with chloroplast. If it is open, air enters inside. That means here oxygen or carbon dioxide exchange will be taken, and if it is closed, then no exchange will be taken. So god cells will help in exchanging of gases. That you need to remember. So this much only they will ask in this topic. You need to remember, upper layer is called as cuticle. Both cuticles are present. And upper epidermis, lower epidermis, palisade parenchyma and spongy parenchyma, and these are double layered, and these are individually located here and there, leaving air spaces. Air spaces are again in the lower epidermis. You can see god cells which will help in exchanging of gases. So this you need to remember for TS of leaf. They won't ask to write theory, but this diagram they will ask you to draw neatly. You need to draw, so neatly you need to draw in your fair notes. How the diagram is there, just you need to take open a fair notes, and just you put the heading TS of leaf or transverse section of leaf. Put the heading. Now, till now in any SSC they have not asked anything, but you will be having much time due to corona, so they may ask for next year. Till now 2014 onwards, no question was there on a TS of leaf. They may ask, chances are there. Why? Because it is important. Three scientists discovered this structure, so that they may ask you. Prepare well, and we'll go to next topic now. So daily while listening about this biology classes, you need to have some rules here. You need to take your fair notes. Whatever class is going on, you need to write or draw. Writing work anyhow, after this video on YouTube, if you open, these are the thumbnails for YouTube, and here you can see under this only I am giving some notes. So if you write the same notes in your book, then your note will be complete. Or otherwise, just you draw the diagram, just to draw the diagram and make the complete notes, and don't try to disturb your notes. Why? Because immediately after school starts, you will be having more. Most importantly, these notes only will be helpful for preparing your for your exams. So after that, you just close that book, and again you revise that book whenever you get a time. All the subject sirs more or less giving the homeworks. Do well and don't do any mistakes. Understood? Okay.